Laker fans, I'm excited to be back on the team, and I'm very excited to see all of you guys at the games. I'm looking forward to giving 110%. Thank you for having me back here in LA. I know sometimes people don't get second chances, but when you do get a second chance, you kind of make sure you do the best you can do, so it wipes away everything that happened the first time. So I'm looking forward to it. I think we're going to have an unbelievable season.
斯台普斯中心，洛杉矶湖人，对于德怀特·霍华德来说，就像黄粱一梦。他的人生被这支球队分割成了两段路。今天的 NBA 故事会，我们来讲讲少年霍华德的奇幻漂流。2009年，奥兰多魔术队打进了 NBA 总决赛。23岁的霍华德同时拿下篮板王和盖帽王，迎来自己的第一个最佳防守球员，入选最佳阵容一阵，拿到全明星票王。他的笑容伴随着杂志封面和电视节目传遍全世界。他是联盟的第一中锋， NBA 的内线无人能应其锋芒。如果你在那时候告诉霍华德，你会在几年之后失去现在的一切，你不再是全明星，不再是最佳防守球员，世人会把你的笑容当作讥讽的对象，那么霍华德一定会觉得你是个疯子。可现实呢，往往就是这么残酷。2012年，27岁的霍华德刚刚迈入巅峰，就在一场改变联盟的四队大交易之中离开了自己效力8年的母队，行鲨鱼奥尼尔之势，君临洛杉矶，披上紫金球衣。他和奥尼尔一样，一样的位置，一样的母队，一样的经历，一样的行事作风，一样的性格，甚至身边都有一个科比·布莱恩特。不同的是，他身边的这个科比·布莱恩特早已经不是奥尼尔时代的那个科比·布莱恩特。
But you guys had a tough time playing together as well. You enjoy it.
Well, I mean, it's different perspectives. So, like, you know, I have a way that I think winning should be done, which is, you know, hard work, and it's, you know, it's a challenging nature.You know, so you and I, if we're working together, you got to challenge me just as I have to challenge you. And a lot of times it makes people uncomfortable. But I don't think you can argue with the results.
Yeah, he said that you didn't give him the ball enough, that you were shooting too much.
I don't know. I mean, it's, I think he had plenty of opportunities. I just think philosophically, our relationship was never going to work.
当我们站在今天回望2012至2013赛季，回望那个注定书写在湖人队史耻辱柱上的赛季，会选择谁来背负失败的责任呢？拥有科比、霍华德、纳什和大加索尔的球队居然在西部屡战屡败，甚至一度跌出西部前八的行列，成为一时笑柄。那个赛季，湖人从内部开始崩塌，科比和霍华德的矛盾让球队在泥潭之中越陷越深。最终，伴随着科比的受伤和季后赛首轮的溃败，霍华德的湖人生涯宣告结束。从此，那个飞天遁地的少年开始了漫长的漂流历程，在迷茫和伤病当中，从亚特兰大到夏洛特，再到华盛顿奇才，他依然偶尔能拿到20个篮板，得到30分，送出几个盖帽，但他不再是那个对比赛举足轻重的球员，他标志性的笑容一点点消失。
He had a comment about me being soft, and I think for years I kind of hated him for saying that because I looked at it the wrong way.I think he was more so talking about my mentality, mm-hmm. not my physique or not,
yeah.
you know, how I am on the court.
Like your edge.
Like my edge. I didn't realize that because of the noise surrounding him saying I was soft. And, you know, I hated him for that moment. But, you know, I realized what he was talking about. I said, oh, okay, that's it.
You got it.
I get it now. So, you know, everybody reaches, you know, different levels of, you know, maturity at different times. And, you know, I think at that time I was ignorant to the level that, you know, he was at, you know. So just, I appreciate you, Kobe. Thank you for saying I was soft. I didn't realize what you meant to know.
跨过山海才能照见平凡的自我，才知道人生并非一片坦途。2019年夏天，辗转多支球队郁郁不得志的魔兽，那个已经34岁的超人，终于再次披上了洛杉矶湖人的球衣，在科比的注视下回到斯台普斯中心，这个他曾经被无数人谩骂和讥讽的舞台。不同的是，他现在只是一个坐在板凳席上的工兵，一个紫金军团的拼图角色，一个球队的底薪球员。他已经没有了雄浑的臂膀和强悍的肌肉，不能亲吻篮筐式的扣篮了，但他终于又一次看到了奥布莱恩杯的曙光，就像十年前一样。这十年与我们很短暂，与他很漫长，花终有重开之日，而人却无再少年。